Hey guys, it's Jesko from AcousticsInsider.com. I wanted to answer a question for you that I got recently. I'm looking at spacing out some panels on the left and right walls, focusing on reflection points. I could also put some angled panels in the wall and ceiling corners, but I'm concerned that my room will end up sounding dead. Can I have too much absorption? So the simple answer is no, you can't have too much absorption as long as you're reducing the reverb time evenly across the spectrum, okay? So the thing is, the actual reverb time that you end up with is far less important than a reverb time that is even across the spectrum. In order to get an even reverb time, or to be reducing your reverb time evenly, you have to use absorbers that are deep enough. So the problem with thin absorbers, typically 2 inches, 4 inches, so that's about 5-6 centimeters, up to 10 centimeters, you'll be reducing the highs and the mids, but the lows will still be left unchecked. And that's going to be a really difficult room to work in. Also, you're not leaving yourself any space to upgrade further down the line. You'll already have reached the limit of how short you can go in terms of reverb time. So if you then want to put more absorbers in your room to actually get the bass in check, you'll be reducing the highs and the mids even more. So the only option you're left with is to get rid of your thin panels and put in new, deeper panels. So I advise, start right from the beginning with deeper panels, even if you're just adding a few, because you'll be reducing that reverb time evenly and you'll be able to upgrade later on. So I hope that answers your question. Come find me on acousticsinsider.com for more information. Make sure to subscribe to my channel. See you soon.